Oh, is this really happening? Hello, everybody. I'm John Carnage, the most trusted man in gaming, and you guys at home are watching the Umlaut pre-show. It doesn't get any more live than this. I'm surrounded by so many amazing people over here manning the chat. The internet chat is my good friend, Wesley. Wesley, stand up over here. How are you, man? So you're going to be the voice of the people online.
Yes, I'm going to be the voice of people online. You guys can come on to umlaut.org live, join the chat room, and just talk about anything you see going on.
Right.
There's some great eBay auctions too to check out. So
yes. There's so much going on, but we can't forget about our man of the streets, the voice of the voiceless.
Yes.
Rob, how are you doing over there? Well, you know, audio things happen all
that's
the time,
you
right? You know it's live. And for everybody at home that's watching right now, you're kind of like a pioneer of mashup and booty and all this stuff. Adrian, how are you? You know about audio things.
Oh, yeah, I know about audio things. When in doubt, see if it's on.
Let me just tell people, booty is a mashup DJ thing, right?
Yes.
You started this.
Yes, I'm the A of A plus D. D is mysterious D. The two of us started Booty back in 2003 in San Francisco before anyone even knew what a mashup was, putting two songs together and turning it into one. And now it's 8.5 years later, and now it seems like mashups are everywhere.
It's kind of like a global thing, right? You guys, it happens in Hong Kong or something? Don't you guys have stuff international?
Yeah, we have about two dozen parties that happen in various places all over the world. And it's funny because mashup culture is a scene that would not exist without the internet. And the whole reason we're able to expand and have parties all over the place is literally because of it's the first music scene that's really is internet-based, like fully, completely internet-based.
Right, and it's amazing that, Umlaut is happening here, where Booty happens. You are a mashup DJ. Are you a fan of Rock Band 3?
I am, actually. I'm a huge fan of Rock Band 3 because some enterprising hackers were able to hack Rock Band, unloading a ton of acapellas and instrumental stems all over the internet. And so, which was a boon to the mashup community because a lot of the songs that are in Rock Band, we can now take and mash them up and create new songs, which I got to say, especially in a Rock Band context, the mashup scene was filled with lots of rap vocals, lots of pop vocals. It wasn't until Rock Band and it got hacked that now we've got mashups with a lot of rock vocals, which I personally love because I'm a rock singer.
And rock it on, right? You got to rock everywhere. We're here rocking it right now. We're doing the Umlaut pre-show. We want to make sure that people know to go to umlaut.org. You can find all the donation information there. It's really easy. It's all right there. So whenever you're doing all this mashup stuff, is there anything you have tried and it just doesn't work? Is there any type of genre of music that doesn't mash?
No, pretty much everything's fair game. Some things are harder than others. A lot of music is in 4-4. You just want that beat. So when you're working with a waltz, which is in a totally different time signature, or let me tell you, Rush. It's really hard to mash up Rush because, you know, they kind of like do crazy time signature things. You know, you can get one nice breakdown of Tom Sawyer and that's about it, you know, things like that. But, you know, so prog rock's a little difficult sometimes. But you know, as far as I'm concerned, everything's fair game.
So, I mean, I think also you've mentioned before that this is kind of like the music of our generation because it's the ADD generation, right? Where's music going to go from there?
Well, I think, we live in an accelerated culture and as music keeps ripping off itself. I mean, you kind of think it's like, okay, the last 50 years of music, everything has probably already been done. So it's just, we're just going to keep recycling ideas. But from that, going on to new things. All art is derivative and music is no exception. So I think it's, you know, people complain about, oh, music was always better. Music was always better 10 years ago, 20 years ago. And I actually kind of disagree. Music's always changing.
So, like you mentioned back in 2003, whenever you started introducing mashup, Did it catch on then? Where people were like, wait a minute, Biggie Smalls and Metallica. I don't understand what the hell is going on.
Oh, man, we had people that were mad at us. Mad. You know, don't do that to Nirvana. You know, and when actually Smells Like Teen Spirit's probably one of the most all-time mashed up songs ever. Because it's the perfect pop song. If it mashes up a Smells Like Teen Spirit, it's the perfect pop song. The great chord progression. You know, so people did not know what we were doing at first. There were some people really embraced it, and then others are mad. Now it's interesting how it's just become part of the musical landscape. The same way that remixes just became part of music culture, mashups are now simply another piece of the puzzle.
Right. Did you ever play DJ Hero?
Yes, I did.
I wanted more mashup stuff in that. I felt like there wasn't enough of that.
What was disappointing about DJ Hero is that you very easily could have made a game, not just a rhythm-based game, but could have made a game about keeping your vocals and your music lined up. Because that is literally a challenge when you're DJing. That could have been the game. Instead, it was just a button masher.
But it was still, it was still a step forward, right, in the rhythm genre. I mean, it was a big introduction. I've never seen anything like that.
You know, I mean, the thing is, it's like it could have, I mean, I guess in the same way that playing Guitar Hero isn't really like playing a guitar, playing DJ Hero isn't anything like DJing, but it could have been.
It could have, it should have. But we want people to know that if you are gonna just like hang out with us, please go to umlaut.org and find it in your heart to just donate. Do it for the kids. I mean, how did you get caught up in all this Umlaut stuff?
I got asked and I said yes, because I think it's a great cause. I love the concept, and it's the season of giving.
There you go. Is there anything going on in the chat, Wesley? Is there any questions or anything?
Yeah. Okay. Actually, well, you were talking about DJ Hero. Skate All Day was wondering what you thought of the addition of the keyboard in Rock Band 3.
Oh, the keyboard in Rock Band 3.
About time.
About time. It added a whole new element of insanity.
It really did. And it opened it up too. And I noticed actually that there's a more pop genre stuff in the later releases of Rock Band, which is, that's perfectly, pop's perfectly fine. And I used to hate pop music, but I'm realizing I was just pretentious and in college.
Hipster. I'm a music hipster.
I was such a music snob. And now I'm just kind of realizing, especially loving mashup culture, songs I thought I hated, I realized that I now love when you put a different vocal on. I always thought I hated rap music, but I realized that it's not rap music that I hate. It's not rap that I hate. It's actually the music that I hate. It's all just a rhythm. But when you throw a different instrumentation, you take a really solid rock band and you put a rapper on top of it, or like a disco song or a new wave song, and you put a rap over it. It's like suddenly I'm hearing the rap in a whole new context. Now I like rap music.
Same thing with me. I think there's a couple of guys out there. There's a girl on a talk that's actually made me, open my mind to a lot of the mashups out there. You, I've been here a bunch of times. Danced. Yeah. Boy, when you're dancing to a mashup, you're just dripping and drenching in sweat.
Well, it's also it's a musical guessing game on the dance floor. If you want to just tune out and just dance your ass off, that's great. But if you want to actually sort of go to a club for somewhat of a cerebral experience, it's a musical guessing game the whole night till the drinks kick in, and then you don't care.
Whenever those drinks kick in, you're just kind of all over the place. Is there anything else going on in the chat?
Yeah, actually, about mashups, about girl talk, Necrobone was wondering if you think we'll start seeing more mashups in the vein of Girl Talk with piles of short samples.
Yes. I can't tell you how many times we get sent mega mixes that everyone's just trying to be Girl Talk. And it's like, I'm sorry, Girl Talk did it. He owns it. He's got it on lock. Right. It's like, stop trying to be the next Girl Talk. Try to be the first you.
That's a big one. Anything else? One more.
One more?
Yeah, one more. Any more?
You know, that's probably about it.
Sure,
I mean, we got some video game related questions.
A lot of video game related.
This is about
video games. Have you ever done that 8-bit mashup?
Yeah. There's a couple 8-bit. I've got a Nine Inch Nails versus Mario Brothers themes.
Sounds amazing.
Wow. We've got I've got a Tetris with DJ Assault. I've got what else do I got? Oh, I've got Foo Fighters versus the theme of The Legend of Zelda.
I am so excited.
I'm gonna drop all those in my in my preset before we get into the rock band show. My first DJ set's gonna include a lot of that.
That is exciting, exciting stuff. I can't wait, and I can't thank you enough for coming over here and hanging us. Thank you for your hospitality. Thank you for Booty. Rob, how you doing, man? Is there anything going on over there?
Rob. Your band is...
Venom here, and I'm at DNA Lounge for an amazing event, Umlaut. Umlaut is a charity benefit to help children's hospitals around the world. And here at DNA Lounge right now, we have a lot of people working hard and diligently to set up for the Umlaut event tonight. Umlaut is going to be a fantastic event with a lot of people getting together to play their favorite rock band songs in a great environment with all their friends and peers in order to benefit children's hospitals. As you can see right now, all these people working hard and diligent to put this show together. It takes a lot of work to put this show together. And you out there can be one of those people helping to help out children's hospitals by going to umlaut.org and donating. It's a simple thing and it helps out children. And everybody loves children. Because children, they're like kittens without fur.
So, welcome back, everybody. Thank you so much for hanging out with us. This is the pre-show for Umlaut. It doesn't get any more pre or show than this, and it doesn't get any louder than Umlaut. And we're hanging out here. There's so much going on. There's just so much swag. This is such a good cause. We're here for the kids. We're here for the Child's Play. I just want to let you guys see some of the swag, some of the ridiculous swag that we have. But this is Muscle March. If you guys ever played this game for the Wii, it's an amazing game with a lot of muscles. Inside of this little thing is an actual thong. And this is the kind of stuff that I'm all about. I mean, look at this. I'm going to be wearing this. Not now, maybe on my thing. But, I mean, this is just incredible. And when you come through the doors, I mean, immediately, right away, you get swag. There's just swag dripping out of everywhere. We should have called this Swagapalooza, man. This is insane. Is there anything going on in the chat?
Yeah, they're wondering what's going on with everything. The donations right now are up to $69 on the umlaut.org.live thing. They can donate through Child's Play,
right,
but if you go there and use Google Checkout, that's the best way to donate. And there's tons of cool eBay auctions. I'm looking at the Crisis Nike sneakers. 39 minutes left on that.
That's right.
And it's up to $200 right now.
$200. I mean, those Crisis Nike sneakers, I mean, where have you seen those? Nowhere. That's a super rare thing. That's incredible. The Super Mario Brothers 3 thing, right? There's a Super Mario Brothers 3 item on eBay right now, and it's only like at $51, right?
Yeah, 53 now.
$53.
4 hours left. But
right, right.
Tons of cool stuff.
That's super cool, and it's signed by the dev team. And that's such a rare thing. In like 30 years, it's going to be worth like millions and trillions of dollars. Well, hopefully. In my world, it'd be worth that. But yeah, there's just so much going on here at Umlaut. There's people gathering in right now. I mean, before you know it, this place is going to be just packed with so many people here for a wonderful cause. We're just raising money. We want to make sure that you guys go to umlaut.org. If you find it in your heart, just to go and just whatever you can. If it's 10, it's $10. If it's a dollar, it's a dollar. Just, you know, find it in your heart to just go ahead and donate. And, you know, this is just going to be so much fun. There's nothing like seeing people get on a real stage in front of a real audience playing Rock Band 3. It's just going to be so much energy. Like, there's nothing comes any closer than, like, connecting with a live audience as you're up there just rocking out to Rock Band 3. Oh, I wish I could do it. Maybe I should just go do it right now. Oh, I need it. I need it. So we have a premier sponsor. They are an incredible group of people, Mad Cats. I think we've all used their stuff before. They have a clip, and I would like to show you guys because they are amazing.
Awesome.
Yes. That's Mad Cats. Those are our premium sponsor. They are an incredible group of people. They're so awesome. I don't know if you guys have seen the swag yet, but downstairs, right below us, is like 400 Rock Band 3 keyboard and game and stand kits delivered by Mad Cats. That's just out of this world. And I think right when you walk through the door, the first 400 people who walk through the door get a free one of those things. That's amazing. That's
epic.
That
is
just
amazing.
Like blows my mind that Mad Cats like, oh, Umlaut, here you go. 400 units of Rock Band 3.
I hope they brought a strong man, though. Strapping man.
There's a lot of strapping men down there. Did you see them sweating? They were sweating. The swag that's downstairs is out of this world. There's some really rare stuff. I think they have a Skyrim Xbox 360.
Yeah.
That's rare. I don't know if you can go to like Best Buy and find one right there. But what's going on with the chat right now, man?
Well, we just got a $10 donation from SC Skafreeman.
$10.
Thank you very
much. Right.
$10. So thank you very much.
So
remember,
much.
Yeah, keep donating. You know, this is a culmination of the whole video game world, but
yes. There's a lot of people from all walks of life right now coming together for Umlaut for a good cause for Child's Play.
Yeah, the fans from Destructoid say hi to us.
Oh, thank you. That's such a nice thing, you know. It's not about Detoid. It's not about these other things. It's about coming together for a good cause. It's about raising money for children in need who need that and just having a really good time tonight. Like I was mentioning before, playing Rock Band 3 in front of a live audience, there's nothing like that. I mean, how many times are you going to... Well, I mean, at home, you're in your mind, you're thinking that you're rocking out. But this is rocking for real, man. This is really taking it to the next level.
Did you... You saw the promo clip that they had.
Yes.
Everybody, they get dressed up. I've seen people with pink hair, glitter.
Pink hair, glitter. There's face painting going on right now for a donation. And not only that, like, the mentality of the nerves, the excitement... The alcohol, maybe, for some people, to get up on stage and sing your heart out, and hopefully you don't fail. But there's no failing. There's only win tonight because you're doing this for a great cause. You're doing it for the kids. What's going on in the chat?
That's good. Swag. Everybody's talking about the swag.
There's got to be a way that we could show the swag. I mean, the one thing that I've been showing is the Muscle March thong. Muscle March thong is worth it in itself, the price of admission. But I don't think there's enough thongs for everybody. But downstairs, there's plenty of swag for everybody. I mean, I've seen a Thor swag thing I've never seen before. I'm in the gaming industry, I've never seen it. But as we mentioned before, Venom, my good friend, was here before checking out all of the swag and all these other things. So he's got some more clips that we have to see because it's awesome.
Umlaut would not be possible if it wasn't for the awesome volunteers and sponsors that helped to put this awesome event together. For the first 400 people that come out here, they're going to get this Rock Band 3 bundle that was donated by Mad Catz, which is an awesome company that makes awesome peripherals, by the way. And they're going to walk away with this tremendous bundle just for coming out here to help support an awesome charity. All these volunteers out here, they're helping to support Umlaut, and you can go and support Umlaut as well by going to umlaut.org right now and help support Child's Play, which is a fantastic charity. And this is why we're all out here today, to help support Child's Play. Fantastic time, and I'm looking forward to this awesome event. Look at this guy, hard at work, seriously. Look at this guy, seriously. He's just hard at work. He didn't even have time to put on his powdered makeup for this video because he's working so hard to put together these 400 bundles that will go out to people that come out here to Umlaut tonight. It's going to be a fantastic event, and I hope you guys keep watching because it's going to be great.
So, we were talking about you guys before. You're Mr. Mad Catz, right? Is that who you are? You are with Mad Catz,
yes.
And thank you so much for everything you've done. That's an incredible amount of stuff downstairs. That's amazing. Thank you.
No problem. I mean, we really want to support not only Child's Play, but also music games in general. Obviously, we play a big role in what we do with Rock Band. So moving forward, we want to just be able to support as much as we can.
Yeah, you guys really went all out with that. Again, thank you so much. How did you get involved with Umlaut?
Well, I think we've been negotiating for a long time, but the biggest thing here is that we want to support the charity. And we thought it just made perfect sense to, I mean, we're obviously very deeply engrossed with Rock Band, obviously doing all the instruments and peripherals for it. So we said, hey, why don't we become the title sponsor? Why don't we donate as much as we can, try to help them out as much as possible? And that's what we did.
Right, you guys have been around for a very long time, since what, like 1989, right?
Yeah, we're a pretty old company, and over the past few years, I'm sure a lot of people have noticed that we're trying to step it up, trying to focus more on premium quality products, and I think we're doing a great job of that.
Yeah, I mean, before, not so much. I mean, Mad Catz was a thing, but now when you look back, Street Fighter 2 sticks, I mean, all of this stuff, you guys really have stepped it up. Not trying, you did it. You did it. You went from that one where, I'm not knocking. I'm just, and now we look at it and we're like, yeah, oh, that's that rare Mad Catz controller that I couldn't find. That was going on eBay for like, I don't know how much.
Like $400.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, I did.
Yeah, but like I said, I mean, we have a different focus now. Obviously, quality and a premium product is what we like. And we like to work with the gamers, especially competitive gaming. We want to make sure we give people something that they're really proud of owning.
Are people still playing the bands and the rocks and the bands and stuff?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people are playing Rock Band still. We're just actually publishing it again this year. We're relaunching Rock Band 3, and we're definitely going to be supporting it further in the future.
Are you playing Rock Band?
I'm not playing tonight, but we do have a band here that's going to be representing Mad Catz. I assembled the band, so I could be like the manager, I guess.
Wow, so you could go up on stage. You kind of have the manager look, right? You just need some dark shades and be like, yeah, that's the band. Spinal Catz. That's kind of good, right?
Yeah, I like Spinal Catz. Yeah.
That's not a bad name, right? No. You have a group of musicians, rock banders from all over.
Yeah. Actually, we got a lot of people. We wanted to definitely do it from the community, so we got some of the best Rock Band players, one of the best drummers, Azu Ride Reaction. He's well known in the Rock Band community, so we got him. We also got some people from the fighting game community and also from the esports community. So we have a good mix of all kinds of people here.
Dude, wow, just all over. There's a Mad Catz 106 Rock Band.
The Mustang Pro Guitar, which you'll probably see throughout the night. We made a Pro Guitar that works exclusively with Pro Mode, and it has 106 keys on it. And it's pretty much teaches you how to play guitar the proper way.
So it's legit.
It's definitely legit. We work very closely with Harmonix and Fender for that.
Yeah, how is working with Harmonix?
It's a blast. I mean, you think about it. I mean, music is a big part of not just gaming but also life. So, working closely with these IPs and these projects, I mean, especially if you like the music, it's really satisfying.
That's awesome. It's so good to hear. And let's not forget, we are here for a good cause tonight. We're here with Umlaut. We're raising money for Child's Play. All you guys have to do is go to umlaut.org. All the information and donation links are all there. We'll just keep it real simple and have you guys go there. But I'm here with Mad Cats. Well, Mr. Mad Cats, Mr. Mad Cats, you're not so mad. Why are cats so mad? Where did the name come from? Because I know it was one thing and then it changed, right?
I really don't know. I've only been with the company for like almost 4 years now, so I don't know exactly where the name came from, but I'm proud to be part of it.
Yeah, I like how you said almost 4 years.
Almost four months,
I thought you were going to say. Almost 4 years. Where are we going next in the level of Mad Cats? What's coming up?
Well, CES is coming up, and we have a lot of big announcements for CES, so just make sure you stay tuned to that.
Okay, definitely. I'm excited. So whenever we're thinking of gaming and controllers and stuff, is there 3D stuff? Are you guys ever...
No, there's a lot of stuff. We don't like to rule out anything. We're working with a lot of partners, and obviously we've already made our foothold in music gaming, fighting games, but we're always looking to expand.
Yeah, and you're looking to expand. I just have to ask, so with Kinect, right? There's no controllers there. What's gonna happen with that if we have all, you know, virtual Minority Report stuff?
I don't think you'll ever get rid of the controller. You'll never get rid of the controller. I mean, obviously, it's nice to be able to play without one. So, I mean, obviously, the Kinect is doing really well. It's done very, very good for Microsoft. But there's still ways to play around that. So we're still in the controller business.
We're not alone. There's people watching out there right now. There may be questions in a chat room. And I would love to hear if there's any questions.
Yeah, there are some questions. Zelmanar actually wants to know, have you guys ever designed any exclusive peripherals for celebrities?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Actually, we have. We've done some special ones. We've done a Gears of War guitar for somebody before, for someone over at Epic Games. And then, I mean, there's a ton of things. I mean, I don't know if I can even talk about it.
Wow, no, okay. We didn't hear any of that. None of that exists. Is there anything else?
Well, I guess you also wanted to know how much detail actually goes into the design of a peripheral.
It's a long process. I mean, designing, like working, well, one of the things is working closely with Harmonix, but the whole design process takes forever. It takes a long time, longer than most people think. Software, obviously, is a different animal, but in working with hardware, you have longer lead times. And it's just working closely with the people that actually design the products and the designers for the game. So it could take anywhere from 6 to 8 months just to get through the design phase. And you obviously, you know, usually every year there's a new music game. So it's really tight timelines and a lot of scheduling that has to go into play. But I don't want to bore you guys with that stuff.
No. I mean, it's actually not boring. It's quite fascinating. I mean, you never think about how much work actually goes into making what you guys do. I mean, just a thought came to me. It's like, the next consoles that eventually come out, do you guys get a heads up on the controllers? I mean, how does that work out?
Well, we have close relationships with the first parties, with Nintendo, Microsoft, Sony. So we do work with them as much as we can to, you know, make sure we're ahead of the curve. So it's always good to work with them because, I mean, obviously they're making the system, so we want to make the controllers.
I can't thank you so much for all of this, all the swag that's downstairs. It's literally like a fort. It's like so high. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for everything that you're doing. Rob, I hear you have another person that's out there, your man in the field. Let me know what's up.
Hear me now. I think I finally got a mic that can work. So, hi everybody. Hi internet. Thank you so much for watching the Umlaut live coverage here. We're live at the DNA Lounge and you can see the lights have gone down behind me. We're just about to get these doors open and get the party started. Andy from Booty up on deck spinning. And with me here, Amanda.
Hi.
You look gorgeous, Amanda. I love it.
Thank you.
And what inspired this outfit tonight?
Panic of not knowing what to wear this morning.
And just so the internet knows, this hair, this is your real hair color, right?
Yes, it is.
Well, not your real hair color, but real for now, right?
For now.
All right. So you are a 3-year volunteer, right? This is your third year, 3 out of 3, volunteering at Umlaut, right?
Yes, sir.
Why do you volunteer for this? What makes you decide to sign up and give your day and weeks away for this?
It's a lot of fun, and Umlaut is, in the past, has raised quite a bit of money for Child's Play, which is an amazing charity. You know, I can just imagine, you know, just think when you're at home sick on the couch, what do you have to do? Play video games. So do sick kids in hospitals. You know, this is a way to provide that for them, kids who aren't old enough to play video games, maybe we can have coloring books or other books just to keep them busy. It's no fun being in a hospital for a long time.
Now, how much work do you actually put into this as a volunteer? Can I ask, what are you kind of like in charge of this year? What's your volunteer role?
I am actually just kind of wandering around selling raffle tickets because I am a little social butterfly, and it's the best way to I can give my time to, but I can still kind of be out there, experience it, watch the show, and it's a really easy way to volunteer.
You're like the raffle fairy right now.
I am the raffle fairy.
All right. Now, we have a lot of people at home who are watching this, of course, online at umlaud.org. And, you know, they might be thinking like, maybe I want to give money to this awesome charity, or I don't know, there's a Steam sale coming up again. What could you say to the internet that, you know, they should consider giving a donation? Because 100% of the money that's donated to umlaud.org goes to the Child's Play Foundation, right?
Yes.
So why should they donate?
Because it's a great deal. It's amazing. We use Google Checkout, which is awesome. Inside Word has told us that they've given us a grant so that they're actually waiving all the fees for us until the end of the year. So 100% of what you do with the Google Donate button will go directly to Umlaut, which we then give to Child's Play.
All right. Awesome. Well, Amanda is going to be around the venue throughout the night. How much do the raffle tickets go for?
It is one for five. Five tickets for $20, and if you really want to go all out, it's 30 tickets for a $100 donation.
Hey, you never know. There might be some people here that are willing to give that much to charity. I sure hope so. What kind of prizes are being given away?
There's some really awesome ones. We have
There's just tables full of stuff down here. I can see like many copies of Guitar Hero.
There's a copy of Dance Central 2. I think it's a special pack as well. I didn't get to see what else is in there. There's like a couple like Dungeons and Dragons board games, some other board game that's like goes for like retails for over $100. So there's some amazing prizes this year.
And I noticed that a lot of people did get into it. Yes, I did say Guitar Hero, and it's a Rock Band, obviously, is the game they're playing. But a lot of companies gave into this and donated and gave to this awesome charity. So big thanks to all of the donations. All right. We also want to say a big thanks to the headliner band tonight. And I believe Carnage has the headliner band with him over there in the VIP lounge. Carnage, what's up?
Me? Oh, I'm so confused. I'm surrounded by beautiful women and wait, girls play video games? What's going on? Who are you, ladies? What's happening? Who are you?
I'm Pixel.
Pixel, you're Pixel. You're
Pastel.
Pastel. That's a name or color. Oh, who are you?
I'm Laser.
Okay.
Brilliance.
Wait, and that, let's not forget you. You're the drummer. Guitarist. Same thing. It's there. You're very excited to be here.
Fantastic.
Oh, that's good to see. It's good to see. What are you beautiful people doing here with all of the different colored hairs? You guys can just be playing what song?
We are playing Combat Baby by Metric and
Potions for Foxes.
Okay. So Combat Baby, Help I'm Alive is the only thing that I think I know by them. You guys are just, colorful hair, all this stuff. What was that? What was going on with that?
Dude, this is just how we roll. We're freaking awesome.
Yeah, okay. No, I mean, I know that. You guys are incredibly awesome and incredibly colorful. And you just are just standing there. You don't care about me. You guys are too cool.
I'm reading your aura.
What's my aura say?
It's okay.
That's terrible. I once took an aura picture and it was purple. Does purple mean anything? Oh, God. You guys are just real big stars, huh? And this guy over here.
Hey.
Yeah, so are you excited to be drumming with all of these beautiful ladies?
I am lead guitar once again.
Yeah. Oh no, that's right, you're playing the guitar. Jeez, I keep forgetting that part.
I'm the drummer.
You're the drummer. And you're the
keyboard.
You're the keyboard. And order. Okay, and
vocals, and she does the bass.
She does the bass, so you guys are making me feel ugly. Because I'm like surrounded by all these cool people. How long have you been doing this?
Forever, since we were born.
It's an immortal. You guys are like the Highlanders of Rock Band 3.
Pretty much.
Yeah, and you just keep doing it.
Before Highlander.
So you're way before Highlander. So you're like pre-Sean Connery. I don't know what Highlander's like before that.
Pre-Sean Connery? Wasn't he?
He was a Highlander. Well, before that, fine. But, I mean, you guys are just, rocking it here. You got your flannel stuff over here, and you got a little question mark shirt. Is there anything going on in the chat?
Yeah, yeah. They want to know, like, how long did it take you guys to actually get really good at Rock Band?
Yeah, that's a great question. How long did that take? Born good.
We were born good.
Okay. Is that it? It's just like a natural instinct to be born good?
Can we cuss? Yeah, we were pretty much born. We were fucking awesome.
Oh, my God. Well, you know, that's great. That's great. What do you say about that? Just naturally inclined to be born great?
It was meant to be. Just
how it was written in the stars.
Yeah.
Okay, it was in the stars. Destiny. Is there any other questions going on?
Well, I think I have a question. I kind of want to know, what's my aura?
Yeah, can you read him real fast?
Well, better would be your animal spirit. Animals are very close to us. And I'm getting a poison dart frog.
Poison dart frog.
Dart frog.
You're a poison dart frog.
I'll take it.
That's
amazing.
I
like cats, but I'll take it.
Oh, I want to know what my animal spirit is since you just read his.
A slug.
A slug. That's great. It's exactly what I want to be. Just put some salt on me, you know, while you're at it. I mean, is there anything else?
Yeah, Dirt Mac wants to know, do you guys actually play any real instruments?
Does it get any more real than how real you guys kill it?
The Rock Band instruments are real instruments.
Well, I mean, yeah, they can be.
No, but they are.
They are. They are. Is there any other real instruments that you play? You still play the drums, right?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. I mean, I'm excited. I'm excited to see you guys go up there and just knock it out of the park. You guys are going to kill it. And all this energy, I'm excited. Thank you guys so much for coming over here and just making me feel great about life and everything else. Rob, you have another person. What's going on? Let me know.
Hey, how you doing, Carnage? It's Rob Roberts here, and I am, of course, out here in the DNA Lounge. We're up here on the second floor, and you can see there's like action going on behind me here, behind us. We're right by the makeup table, so there's lots of people, lots of bands I'm able to catch as they're on their way to get their makeup done. Or, since your makeup already looks fabulous, I'm joined by Stephanie, who is, I think, moral support, right?
No, I'm in a band.
But you're moral makeup. Support for the band getting makeup.
Yes, bandmate is getting his makeup done.
Awesome. So what band are you with tonight?
The Golden State Akari Warriors.
That is an awesome name, especially for anybody that remembers the game. Does it have to do with the game?
Don't I look like...
I get... Well, you're missing an Uzi, but I guess they don't let you bring those in here, huh?
Well, we'll have our props when we go get our picture done in a bit.
Nice. All right. What song are you guys doing tonight?
Doing Only the Good Die Young by Billy Joel.
Nice. Did you know when you bought the band package, like, this is the song I want to do, we got to do a tribute to Billy Joel, or did you have to, like, I don't know, did you have to argue amongst the band to figure out what song you wanted to do, or what?
I personally wanted to do something else, but I'm a longtime Billy Joel fan and a New Yorker, so, and a pianist, so I played Billy Joel my whole life. Of course, I was not going to say no.
So you're doing keyboards tonight?
Yes, I am.
That's going to be awesome. Now, did you guys actually do any, like, types of rehearsal to kind of prep for this?
Yes, of course. We had to practice. We have to kick ass. There's no question. So, yes, we think we're going to rock tonight.
Very awesome. So this is obviously an awesome charity. The Child's Play charity is awesome. Why do you think people out there on the internet watching here at umlaut.org should consider contributing to this charity?
I'll give you a personal example. My mother is superintendent of a hospital and school for disabled children in upstate New York, and they have received computers and other technical supplies from Child's Play. So I actually personally know people and know the kids who've been affected by this, and it's made a huge difference for inner city kids who wouldn't have access to technology otherwise.
That is so awesome. Yeah. That's an amazing story. I don't think you're going to get a much better story than that. That's great. Is this your first year at Umlaut, or is this like the third year you've been here, second?
Second year I'm here attending, first year performing.
Okay. Did you kind of watch everything go on last year and say, I want to be on that stage next year? How did you come to the consensus?
That was pretty much it, yeah. It looked like a lot of fun last year. Bands did some crazy things, and when this year rolled around, totally, why not?
All right, awesome. Well, you guys are getting your makeup done. You're not getting your makeup done. What kind of makeup's being done over here at the makeup table?
We're just going crazy, dramatic, rock star. My bandmate now is going with the whole Clockwork Orange theme and getting the big eye and going to be all sorts of crazy. So,
is there going to be like fire pyrotechnics display during the show, perhaps?
A violin? And we may have to smash a few things, but we'll see.
Now be careful. You don't want to smash things and, you know, then destroy property. We don't want to hurt anybody.
Exactly.
Have you checked out the swag table or the raffle table?
I haven't yet, but I have noticed beyond a big stack of keyboards down there, which, of course, I'm very curious what they're all doing there. So.
Now, I was going to say, unfortunately, one thing we can't do is we can't take the camera downstairs right now to show you all of that because, you know, the whole live bit and all that. But there's just stacks and stacks of Rock Band that are being given away and all these things on the tables and so forth. So.
Yeah.
All right. All right. Well, we are going to go to, I think we're going back to Carnage, who's got Telltale with him.
Telltale. This is not just a regular Telltale guy. And albeit Telltale is phenomenal. This is SAG. SAG wearing what is it? You're like, is this a Marilyn Manson thing?
No, it's a corset from Dark Garden here in San Francisco.
Okay. What is this supposed to help your posture? Is this going to help you sing better?
It helps posture, and also when I do events, I'd like to be everyone knows who I am if they don't recognize me and. Well, this helps.
This really just makes you stand out. I know you now. I will always know you. I mean, I thought I've worn some really cool stuff like thongs and things, but I may have to find me one of these so I can just. What about the breathing?
If it hurts, you're doing it wrong.
Okay.
Or really right, but that's not my bag. No, I mean, it's just like getting a hug.
Right. It is. It's like getting a hug and never letting go.
Yeah.
But you're here with Telltale, right?
Well,
You're here with a lot of things. Telltale and Umlaut.
Yeah.
Umlaut is you.
Yeah.
I mean, not just, okay, right. But it was a spark that probably started from you at like 3:30 in the morning. Where did Umlaut?
Well, actually, yeah. So, actually, the long story is years ago, I used to live in Boston. I went to Emerson College, and I'm originally from Detroit, but. Harmonix did a play test, signed the NDAs, and they're like, hey, we have this game for you. You use this, and handed me a Guitar Hero guitar prototype. And I played it, and after playing it, it's like, this isn't about score, this is about rocking out. So I always wanted to do this event that focused on the performance of Guitar Hero Rock Band. And then 3 years ago, or 4 years ago, there was an event called Fundraiser. That was announced day of. They took over a bar and was just just playing at a bar rock band, and it packed the small venue. And I thought, you know what? There's a good audience here to have a bigger event for Child's Play and focusing really on the performance and all that. So it was myself, Chris Kohler, and Joe Marquette that we got together to make Umlaut, this big show that you'll be seeing tonight.
Right. I mean, it's a big show. It's a lot of fun, a lot of wonderful people. If you guys can find it in your heart, just go to umlaut.org, and you can find all the information on how to donate. There's so many things going on. We have silent auctions, right? We have eBay auctions.
Yep.
We have raffle ticket things going on downstairs. And, I mean, there's so many amazing, rare things. How did all that come to you?
Well, mostly Chris Kohler. Chris Kohler heads up all the prize and all that. And it's all the game studios and publishers and developers and all that accumulate all this stuff for PAX or whatever convention and all that. And then don't have anything to do with it. Or like, we'll find good homes for it. And so they just load the truck and dump it all over to us. And we give it out as our door prizes and all that for the event. And the really good stuff becomes raffle. And the really good stuff goes into the silent auction and eBay auctions.
I don't know how you guys got your hands on one of those Sonic statues. There's only 1,000 of them. And one of them's here. One of them's here. You know, I may have to go write something down. Even if it's like $15, right?
Yeah, I haven't checked out the bid yet.
No, the bid, I haven't checked it out either, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna go a little higher than 15. Maybe 1,500. I don't know. You can't put a price on some of these things.
Yeah, no, it's, you know, we leave it to, I mean, we have so much really good stuff, but then there's the stuff that bubbles up, and it's like, you cannot go to the store and buy this. So that's mostly the determination of having that to make it a silent auction, or the eBay auctions, which are available to you right now. If you are at umlaut.org, you'll see on the sidebar the list of things, and we have assigned Super Mario Brothers 3 NES card.
That right there is history. Yeah. That for a long time was the number one selling game. For a long time. And it's signed by the dev team, right?
Yeah.
That's incredible. I don't know how you guys got that.
I don't ask questions.
Don't ask questions. And I don't think it's, I think it's a little, it's worth a little bit more than $50. I think it's worth a lot more than that. That's a piece of history. It's not like you're going to come across one of those in an attic somewhere. Oh, it's signed by the dev. Oh, that's common. Let's go trade that in, get $2. But where did the name Umlaut come from?
Gentleman by the name of Rob Sabal. I hope I'm not saying it.
Oh no, don't worry.
We were trying to find a name for it, we were thinking all these ideas, and it was Chris Kohler's friend that said, well, what about Umlaut? And I'm like, well, maybe that's it. And then we realized, no, that's the name. Yeah.
It's a great name. It has nothing to do with meditation, right? It's like, umlaut.
Yeah, when people are like, what's that? It's like, it's an umlaut, but louder.
Oh, wow. wow. So, we're not alone. There's people in a chat room.
Yeah.
Is there any questions?
They're curious to know, like, how much time and effort went into putting this whole thing together.
All the time.
Not enough time, right?
We definitely expanded this year organizationally. So there's about 15 people on what I'll call a full-time staff, but we're all volunteer. No one gets paid. And it really does take us most of the year to get things together, and then the 3 months before is just 2-11 of just straight up work and getting all the pieces together and all that, and dealing, making sure the bands that you're going to see tonight and whatever time it is at 8 o'clock, and just making sure that we're doing everything we can to make sure their performance is unique, while making sure they're not doing something really stupid like an open flame. But, making sure and deal with that. And then sponsors who really want to help the show out, really want to support Child's Play, and, making sure that we're presenting them in a way that shows that the commitment they have to all the families around the world through the children's hospitals. So it's a big undertaking.
I can imagine. It's a huge undertaking.
I take this whole week off. It's just vacation time.
It's not really that much of a vacation. I mean, it is, but it isn't. I mean, you're doing something out of love, right? You love this. You have to love this.
You definitely have to love this. And I'm. It's amazing looking out here and just seeing all this stuff coming together. It's a rush. I know I'm getting kind of teary-eyed in the moment, but just I'm finally having that moment to go,
it happened.
It's happening. And a lot of people are making this really awesome. And so can you.
Yes.
By donating or doing the eBay auctions. Now, the one thing I'll say is that Umlaut is a Google Grants recipient. And that has made the Google checkout fees waive, so really, please donate. It is all going to Child's Play. So please, make that number on the top of that screen go up, because this also shows that you're out there willing to support us. So please spread the word right now and get everyone to watch, and please, please donate.
Awesome. So we have one more question. Do you have anything happening in the chat?
Yeah, actually one question I thought was pretty cool is, we have fans from all over watching this. Have you thought about maybe expanding this?
It's definitely not for lack of want, but it's, so we're our own nonprofit, and that means we're ourselves responsible for the organization, but we both haven't really figured out what we need to do to expand out. And just right now, we really want to stick to being in here and what we know best. But we are
considering certain things to, you know, not the big show like tonight, but some smaller things we're kind of looking into. But what also helps with that is just email us, you know, saying, hey, I enjoyed the show, whatever, you know, keep a dialogue with us, because that makes all of us know that you're out there. So, yeah, we don't have any plans at the time, but...
Well, thank you so much, Zach.
Thank you. There's thank a, you guys.
Oh, oh, thank no you problem, so Zach. Much. No. Let me wipe my hand up. Thank you so much for everything. This is your vision, and it's coming true. And we also have another vision. We have a Telltale vision. They gave us a clip, and we would love to see this clip. So thank you so much. Thank you, and thank you, Telltale.
Take care.
Rated T for Teen.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to convince your 1931 self to build a rocket-powered drill to break you out of jail?
Precisely!
Isn't a Dilophosaur bite. None of the other dinosaurs are poisonous.
I knew they'd gotten out somehow, but I never
knew about this? You knew?
We always knew that Jurassic Park the game was going to be something special on iPad 2. But we couldn't have known just how well the game would work on the platform, not just technically, but as an experience. iPad 2 offers a completely new way to experience the very same game that you'll see on full-size consoles and computers. Touching the screen offers a brand new level of interactivity with the park and its creatures, but beyond that, it feels completely natural. The power of iPad 2 and its dual-core A5 processor has allowed us to deliver features like normal mapping, specular lighting, and hardware acceleration. On top of that, using AirPlay and Apple TV, you can play on your iPad 2 and watch the cinematic adventure on your big screen TV. iPad 2 is a phenomenal way to experience Jurassic Park the game, and it's out now on the App Store.
Hey guys, it's Rob back here at the DNA Lounge, second floor, where it's starting to fill up in here. The doors are open. Everybody's dancing to A&D Booty. And, you know, as more and more people come in, I'm trying to pull people so you guys can see them on the internet. People that just kind of, that I notice. And I don't know what it is about this guy here, Jay, but something made me notice him. How you doing, Jay?
I'm doing okay. How are you?
I am awesome. Okay, I got to ask. Hat. What's the story of the hat?
It was my Halloween costume this year. I went as a water buffalo. It was complicated, but I kept the hat. I'm singing in a band tonight, so keep the hat.
What made you decide to go as a water buffalo? I hope nobody shot you. My gosh.
No, I mean, it was at Party City, and I'm like, oh, that hat's just too great. You know, it's from the Flintstones. You know, it's I love it.
Awesome. Now, Jay, you're in one of the bands that's actually performing tonight, right?
Right.
And what's the name of your band?
4 out of 5 Doctors.
4 out of 5 Doctors choose Jif, or?
4 out of 5 Doctors choose to sing at Umlaut this year.
Very nice. Now, are you a doctor, or you just play one at Umlaut?
No, my brother-in-law, who's actually our guitarist, is a doctor. And we just kind of stuck with it and just kind of roll with it.
That's awesome. So, now, is this your first Umlaut, or have you been to the event before?
This is actually my third. So, I've been doing this for a while.
Awesome. Is this the first time that you've actually done a band?
No, third band as well.
Oh my gosh. So you've been doing it each and every year, right? So do you find that you try to outperform yourself each year?
I think this year we're going to try to put it over the top. So I'm excited. We're playing a song that we love, so...
What song is it you guys are doing, or is it like a secret to everyone?
Well, it's on the internet, so it's not really a secret to everybody, but the greatest song of all time, We Built This City on Rock and Roll by Starship.
And that is an awesome Rock Band 3 song as well, because it's got the keyboard stuff and all that.
It's got harmonies, it's got keyboard, it's got everything.
Do you have like the full 7-person band going, or just...
Four.
Oh, out of 5 doctors. How could I forget? Of course, absolutely. So if you've been at the show each year for the past 3 years, what are you kind of noticing is different this year that you haven't seen before?
This year, the live streaming is awesome. Props to you guys. Also, too, I mean, it just keeps getting bigger every year. And I mean, that's great to see, because I mean, it's for a great charity. So that's why I'm here. That's why I think everybody else is here.
I was thinking it might actually sell out this year, like, you know, because the band packages sold out very fast this year, right?
Yeah, it was within a day and a half. So, yeah, that's great.
So did you know at the end of last year's event, you're like, I'm going to come back and we're going to do this band again? Or was it something that kind of came together more at the last minute?
Yeah, each year I'm kind of like, I don't think I'll ever do that again. But then, you know, December rolls around and I'm like, oh, I got to drag Rock Band up from the storage unit. And like, it's like, oh, let's play some Rock Band.
Now, Jay, if you stop by, again, the internet can't see all the awesome loot that's downstairs, so I'm trying to have our guests kind of explain some of this to them. But what kind of stuff have you seen downstairs that you're like, wow, that's cool stuff?
So, yeah, so if you get here soon enough, you can get a entire Rock Band 3 for the Wii, including the keyboard, which is phenomenal.
Yeah.
And then there's always the raffles, always got good stuff. And then, you know, the swag table, you know, it's always great. And, of course, there's a bar.
That's right, there is a bar. But I noticed you don't have a drink in your hand. What's up with that?
Yeah, my wife took it.
Those things happen. Well, Jay, I want to thank you so much for being here on the live stream. Good luck. About what time are you guys on?
8:57.
8:57, you should be towards the top of it. So 4 out of 5 doctors choose to go to umlaut.org and continue watching the feed and donate to the Child's Play charity, an awesome cause that brings out the finest of water buffalo from all around. All right, we want to toss back over to Carnage, because Carnage has one of the most important people behind tonight's event. It's we're in his house, we're partying in his house. So I think we're going to go check back in with Carnage, who wants to talk to the owner of DNA Lounge.
Wow, really?
All right.
So this is just so incredible. I mean, it's not often I actually get to meet the owner of a club, let alone one of the hottest clubs in San Francisco. Jamie, this is your place. Thank you for your hospitality. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for coming.
Thank you so much. How did you get involved with Umlaut?
Well, this is our second or third year that we've done this. They, you know, they came to us and said, let's, you know, we want to do this show, and it sounds great. So we're a great cause. So here we are. And, you know, I've been... you know, pretending to run a club for a decade, so I figured having people pretend to be in bands, you know, is a good fit.
Pretending to run a club. I like how you said that. Pretending to run a club, one of the hottest clubs out here, and you're like, ah, it's no big deal. Before we were talking, you're like, I'm amazed at how much equipment. This whole place is one giant thing of equipment.
We do have a lot of gear, it's true.
Here. But did you see all the swag downstairs?
It's out of control. When they said they needed a 2 p.m. load-in, you know, I was like, what? What are you doing? But then I saw, all the stuff they had to carry. It makes sense. So that's all giveaways?
All the stuff downstairs. Maybe you should try to get one. But, yeah, there's a lot of giveaway stuff down there. There's more giveaways in a silent auction room. There's giveaways online. We're doing eBay stuff. It's just giveaways everywhere. They should call this Swagapalooza. There's a thong in that little thing over there. It's just crazy.
You know, we actually had an event called exactly that. It was some other tech industry.
Really?
Yeah, oh. They called it that. Yeah.
Swagapalooza. It's just swaggerific then. We'll call it swaggerific. We'll change it. Fine. If somebody else called it, we'll call it something else.
You don't want to do that.
Yeah, we don't want to get sued. Well, okay, so you're typically used to having people come here, get wild and crazy, right? Yeah. How are the video game nerd people? How are we whenever we come and do Umlaut?
Well, you know, there's video game nerd people at one of our regular parties at like Booty or something, you know, they just look like everyone else, right?
But tonight is our night.
You know, I love the cosplay that's going on with some of the bands here. I think that's the coolest part of this. You know, it's fun.
It's certainly a lot of fun. I mean, you've been in the industry for a long time. Well, the management club industry, but before you did this, you did something with the interwebs? What was that?
I did something with the interwebs. I was one of the founders of Netscape. I wrote the first version of the browser on Unix.
That's huge. That's like, you're legendary. And you're just like, ah, I found that, Netscape was a thing. That was all I used. I loved it.
I'm glad to hear it.
I didn't use the other guys. I used Netscape. Oh my gosh. So we're not
Microsoft tone here. We don't allow that.
No. Well, I like the Fox now. I use the Fox a lot. But we're not alone. There's people watching us. There's a chat room filled with people. Maybe they'll have questions for you. This guy is kind of a big deal. So you may have to have some big questions. Yeah, he's a big deal. That kind of you are. You are the man. Is there any questions in the chat?
Yeah, I just want to know, like, how hard was it to set up a club?
Yeah. Set up the club?
Yeah.
Well, it was actually kind of ridiculous. The club's been here since 1985. It's been a San Francisco staple forever. And when I took over, it was during a period of time where the city was really trying to, having a war on nightlife. They were trying to shut down all the clubs. And it was kind of why I got into this. It was like partly a political battle. I saw the clubs going away, and I was like, no, I'm going to stop that. That's wrong. So we had this huge battle to retain the permits the club already had. Like, we're allowed to stay open 24/7, basically. And most clubs have to close at 2. So the fight to keep that, you know, we were in court a lot, with lots of hearings. So it took a year and a half before we were allowed to actually open. But you know, that was 10 years ago, and we're still here, and we're, you know, winning awards every year, so it's going pretty well.
So you fought for my right to have a good time?
I did technically fight for your right to party. I did.
That's amazing. Again, that's huge. And you've seen a lot of stuff over the years. I mean, we have to go back to the mashups and Booty. I mean, did you ever think that was going to be the thing?
Oh man, we love Booty. It's such a fun party. And it started off just as a monthly, but it's like it just kept growing. Every event was like bigger and bigger and bigger, and you know, it's unstoppable. Like, now Booty's every Saturday and packed all the time.
It's always packed. I was here one night where they did like a Ziggy Stardust show with the Blood, and I mean, it's more than just mashups. You guys have like a variety show that happens.
Yeah, they do a little like sort of drag burlesque thing every night in the middle of Booty, and they also have the live band Smash Up Derby who perform mashups live, which is pretty unique.
God, that's so funny. I remember seeing people hanging from the ceiling too. It's also like, yeah, circus stuff. Oh god, a lot of aerial stuff. Oh my gosh, is there anything else?
You know what? I did want to give like a quick shout out to Bob the Cat and Ronan for both donating to the Umlaut
event.
So
right.
It's great. Yeah, the donations keep coming. Question-wise, I think a lot of them are curious, like, how hard is it to get into, like, a VIP room?
Oh, they want that VIP. That's a great question, the VIP question.
Well, we're not really that kind of club. You know, we have two rooms here, and generally it's like the back room is just, it's just another DJ, you know, it's just another dance floor, usually a slightly different take on the same party going on. We do, like, you know, you can get table service, but, you know, that just, you know, you rent a booth and you buy a bottle. It's not, you get your own little private velvet rope for you and your six friends, but it's not really, we don't have private rooms or anything like that. So, you know, you know, everyone's welcome. It's not a very exclusive thing here.
Yeah, we could pretend, right? We could close these curtains here and be like, nah. Nah, you can't. Okay, yeah, see, everybody's a star when you come here. It's just so incredible. Any other questions?
No, everyone's just, they're really getting into the music in the background.
Oh, they hear the, see, that's like, that's, yeah. Mashup right now. That's Adrian, right?
That's Adrian spinning right now. Yeah. He's the one of the two. Adrian and Ginger are the ones who put on Booty, and they're amazing. There's also, go to their website. You can download mashups. That's, if you're into that, like, it's fantastic.
Yeah, no, it's all over the place. And you guys give away CDs all the time. I mean, like, Booty has this, like, here's a ton of CDs.
Toss them out by the handful every party.
Well, thank you so much for your hospitality, for helping us out with Umlaut. It's an incredible event. This is going to be a lot of fun. There's nothing like seeing people get up on stage, maybe for some of them their first time, in front of real people, not the interwebs people. Anybody can be an internet gangster, right? And get up in front of people and actually play Rock Band 3. This is going to be a heck of a night. Thank you so much.
I wanted to mention, since you're watching this online, we do this every night. Every night we're open, actually 24/7. We always have the cameras going on our website. You can watch a live webcast of every show we do, every band that's on our stage. So, you know, even if you can't come down here, you can still enjoy the show.
That says a lot, man. It's that brain. It's that tech brain that you. I know you say it's a long time ago, but it's still there. It never goes away. And thank you again. Thank you. And so I hear that we have Rob, right? Rob, is he ready? Oh, we're going to somebody else. We're going to Venom. Now, see, this is what threw me off is that before when we were looking at all the swag.
Talk to me because the other guy's not ready.
Oh, well, no. I wasn't ready. See, what happened was we were here before when we were setting up, and Venom was looking at the swag, and what happens is it's just amazing. And you guys have to see this clip. This clip is, to me, it's the highlight of my life. It makes me feel so good. So there you go. Venom.
Hey, so even I'm trying to help out here at Umlaut, trying to put stuff together. Oh, Lord.
See? Fantastic. As you can see here at Umlaut, they have fabulous prizes
for the raffle. Oh my God, sorry about that, Stacy. That was kind of ridiculous. That was totally ridiculous. Somebody's hat. See, I tried to help, but maybe I should stick to my Dave job of interviewing. Good thing I didn't take the television out. All right, let's try this one more time. Yay, there you go. Total win. Absolutely, total win. That was fantastic. Thank you, Stacy. I'm sorry I made a fool out of myself. I was just trying to help out to help the children. It's like, well, we have some fabulous prizes here for people that come here. They're gonna be doing a raffle and they have some awesome prizes, things I've never even seen before. Like, really, look at this. What is this? Risk your life for Metal Gear Solid. That's what I just did. I could have died for Metal Gear Solid. These are some amazing prizes that we have here. Like, really, come around here. This is the beautiful Stacy. She's one of the awesome volunteers for...
My name is Raphael.
Raphael. It's like... Look at these top secret prizes that are a part of the Umlaut raffle. That all the proceeds go to benefit Child's Play, an awesome charity. But look at this. I don't even know what's in here. It could be the Wii. It could be information about Jimmy Hoffa, JFK. Who knows? Look, what is this? Assassin's Creed Encyclopedia Britannica? What? I don't even know the things, the amazing prizes. I mean... Yeah, I may have this at home, and this is a fantastic, fantastic raffle prize. But look down there. What is Thor? A key to Thor? I don't even know. What is this? These are. I work in the video game industry, and I don't even know what some of these prizes are. So, all I gotta say, you keep watching out there. Support Umlaut, because there's gonna be a whole bunch of people having a blast tonight, and you can support children and Children's Hospital by going to umlaut.org and donating to help Child's Play. So this is Venom, over and out.
Hey guys, it's Rob back at the DNA Lounge up here on the second floor. And, you know, unfortunately Venom wreaked a little havoc on the prize table, but I thought I'd bring up one of the volunteers from the prize table to talk to us. Unfortunately, had to clean up that mess. I'm so sorry.
Dude, seriously, as if we don't have enough to do. Hello.
No, it's all good. Everybody's having fun. Guys, this is Keth. Hi, Keth.
Hi, Rob.
And Internet. Don't forget the entire Internet watching us right now.
Hello, Internet.
Now, one of the reasons I wanted to talk to Keth right now is because we've had a lot of people that have come up here who it's like their third year at Umlaut, which is awesome because, you know, that means people want to come back. But Keth, you are a first-year attendee, right?
I am indeed my first year.
You're losing your big V tonight. With Umlaut.
I am. No V's on my cheek, though.
That's like, right. That's right. So. All right. So, Keth, what made you decide not only to come to Umlaut, but that you wanted to volunteer?
So, I came to Umlaut originally. A lot of my friends have come, and they've said just what an awesome time they had. I was like, okay, I have to get in on this. And I'm the kind of person, I like to give back,
you know, if I'm gonna come, I mean, yeah, I want to come and like see how awesome it is, but at the same time, I want to help out and I want to do what I can to give it a good shot, because this is a great charity and I love, nonprofits are in my blood and I want to support them as much as I can. So why not come experience it and volunteer at the same time? Just jump all in.
What do you mean by you have a lot of nonprofit in your blood?
Well, I've worked for nonprofits in the past. I also come from a long volunteer background. I volunteer with the Red Cross. I volunteer with several other organizations. So, and I worked at Wikipedia for a year. So I've got a good nonprofit background going.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much for all that you do. That's amazing. So what have you been told to expect tonight?
Everything and anything. I've already seen a guy with an 80s wig running around. I saw somebody, I think he's with the Loyal Order Water Buffaloes from Flintstones.
Yeah, we just had one of the Water Buffaloes on. It was awesome.
Oh, that's excellent. I saw him running around. That made me a very happy camper. So I've seen some Devo people running around. I'm basically expecting everything tonight.
Now, you are working down at the prize table, and that's the raffles. And we had the raffle fairy on earlier to tell us about like some of the tickets and the prices that they're going for and everything. But now that folks have actually been coming in, have you seen that there's been a lot of people that are going to the table and saying, ooh, I want that, I want that?
I have. I'm actually with Band Check-In. I'm under the wrong sign.
Oh. If I knew how to read, I'd figure that out.
Well, I know you haven't gotten there in school yet. It's okay.
It's all right. All right. All right. So
I'm actually with the bands.
Okay. Oh, so you can actually say, I'm with the band.
I am with the bands.
So what exactly is it that you do?
So as the bands come in and get ready to go, we check them in, make sure that all their members are there. If you're watching and you're coming as a band, don't talk to me until all your people are here. Seriously. And then we get them all their stuff together and then send them up for pictures and get them and check them in to go on stage.
So you're watching like all these people that are dressed up. Have you seen that any bands are coming through and they maybe don't look like they're ready to rock?
Not yet. No, everybody seems to be pretty excited, ready to go, as long as all their members are here.
That's very important. Do not come check in without all of your members.
Seriously. If you don't have all your members and I can't check you in, you don't get your swag ticket, and it's not pretty.
All right. Now, lastly, we're about ready to go to a huge interview with Carnage. Carnage has Harmonix, who made Rock Band 3. What do you think it is about Rock Band that make people want to pay money to play it on stage for charity?
It's such a fun game. I mean, it's the ultimate party game, number one. And there's such a performative aspect to it. I'm an anthropologist, so I'm going to try not to get real, you know, like, exciting about it. But there's such a performative aspect to it. And there's this whole thing about, you know, showing off your performance, not just to your friends, but you know what? I can rock a house with my friends, and I want to prove that I can rock it to an entire house of people and raise money for an awesome charity at the same time.
All right, well, Keth, thank you so much for coming up here. Thank you for volunteering. Thank you for all you do. You're awesome. And I will make sure that if I check in any bands, they will all be present. All right. Now we're going to go back over to Carnage. Carnage has Harmonix with him,
yeah.
The folks behind the game.
It's real. This is real. I really have Harmonix. The sentient being, you guys together merge and become Harmonix, right?
Yeah.
And listen.
About it,
and you've been dancing the whole time. There you go, Harmonix. What do you guys do for Harmonix besides being the sentient being of Harmonix?
So we're on the community team.
Okay.
So we go on the road. We do PR, the web stuff. So that's Eric, Aaron. I'm John. You may know Aaron as HMX Henry. That's Mr. Pope. We hang out.
You hang out.
Yeah.
You guys are like roadies, like gaming roadies.
We are roadies, we're bouncers, we're good time Charlies.
You said bouncers. Has anybody gotten rowdy at one of these things?
Not tonight, but yeah, historically.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, the night is young.
They'll get drunk and like throw guitars around and like, they're plastic, but they're still kind of expensive, so you have to stop people from doing that.
To be fair, we actually have already bounced one person tonight. There was a kid who was playing up here who was probably 10 years old who was so happy with himself, but he walked off with a guitar, like sort of strutting down the way. We were like, hey, come back here with that. It's not yours.
Wow.
Yeah, watch out.
No, I mean, have you ever seen anybody get hit with the guitar? I mean,
we've had people smash guitars on stage. We've had people who are like inebriated to the point of being unable to perform in any way, shape, or form. Yeah. Well, we tested that too.
Okay, so you guys are, you know, with Harmonix and everything. Is there ever going to be like a rhythm wrestling game? Because you are rocking the greatest shirt. I'm not going to lie. That shirt is absolutely romantic. It's everything I've ever wanted in a shirt, except I just don't know. It feels weird with the WCW belt.
Yeah, I think this is like the only photo they could get without paying Vince McMahon.
Okay.
So, like, that's why they chose this still. He's really unhappy here. He's just like,
He's crying.
He's got little super tiny nipples and a big front butt.
They're Tic Tacs. Yeah. When you become a pro wrestler, your nipples become Tic Tacs. I know because I became one. That's no joke. Where did the carnage come from?
But I think Hulk Hogan beat us to the punch with the Wrestling Connect game.
Yes. Have you played it?
No, I'm not. I've not played it.
It's okay. Our good friends at Reaver work on that game, so it's good.
I've wanted to play that game so bad because that game, it's real.
It is a game that you can put into your Xbox
and you can be like, you know, throw your hands up. Yeah.
You do your own intro. You do your own like quick interview throws. Like it's pretty thorough.
Are we plugging this game right now?
We're doing it.
Yeah, it's great.
Rock Band 3. What's your favorite track from Rock Band 3?
Oh, God. From Rock Band 3, Rainbow in the Dark by Dio.
Dio, he wanted to play on the moon, right? He never got a chance to do that. I think that's what Dio wanted to do. He wanted to be the first person to play the guitar on the moon.
Wow.
How come I know this and you don't?
I don't know.
He's 4 feet tall. But he's 6 feet tall now. Yeah. I mean, so Rock Band 3, favorite song.
Rock Band 3, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yeah. Can't go wrong with that one.
Pretty safe.
That's safe. You mean you still have to rock out?
Oh no, people love it. Like that is like that's such a standard. That's like that's the vanilla of the Rock Band 3 soundtrack. Everybody loves it. Like you can't not enjoy it.
You've got moves, man. I see you move. There you go.
That's why Huey Lewis in the News is my favorite track.
Oh, nice. Rock Band 3.
You said Huey Lewis in the News.
Yes.
I saw them live.
Really?
There you go.
And the News.
And the News.
Not just Huey.
I don't take money. It took a lot of my and time and everything to see him live, and wow,
it was
so worth it. Everybody with the fanny packs and the lawn chairs were really having a great time.
It's the championship belt of the suburbs, the fanny pack.
Well, so we are just so happy to have had you guys here with us. I mean, this is just so much fun. And is there any questions in the chat?
Yeah, there's actually a ton of questions. I just got a dragon thrown at me. It's amazing. But I think they want to know, like, you know, what can Harmonix do to keep the platform fresh? How about Dubstep Hero?
Dubstep Hero, that's a great thing.
Officially banned from the Rock Band forums, whoever asked that question. Maybe with the new Korn record out. We just found out the new Korn record is dubstep influenced today, and also that they hate President Obama, which is weird.
It's two strikes against Korn.
We put out new DLC every week. So we just put out Stevie Wonder a few weeks ago. This week is, what's this week? More Queen with 9 Queen songs.
Okay.
I mean, the platform's plenty fresh.
Oh, well, that's...
Dubstep to that.
And I just want to thank everybody here. I want to thank you guys. I want to thank Umlaut. I want to thank DNA. I want to thank Mad Cats. Mad Cats has just really killed it. You guys have killed it. He's killing it right
there.
I'm killing it. He's killing it. We're all loving. We're all friends. Rob killed it. Everybody's killing it. And thank you so much. Mad Cats, thank you so much, Mad Cats. You guys are amazing. You guys, Mad Cats, with all of the Mad Cats stuff everywhere.
The Mad Cats.
We have one clip. We want to give you guys one clip. Just take it. Take it.
In the summer sky.
Are we all in the shot?
Oh, hey, so we're here.
Yes.
And now, before you know it, it was over. It was like an hour and a half just already passed. And I mean, I've learned a lot about myself. I learned that, you know, Umlaut is loud, really loud at times.
Unless unfortunately, your mic doesn't work. Then
it was
it's
so
a
loud.
Quieter.
It was so loud and destroyed your mic.
Yes, exactly. They tried to turn it to 12 and it broke it. That's actually what happened.
They went one too much. They went from 11 to 12.
Yes.
We know that mics just don't work under that 12 technology.
Yes, unfortunately, 12 will just break everything.
12 will quantum leap you out of your body. Like you get hit by a 12 and you just zap, you're gone. I want to tell you, please go to umlaut.org. Don't forget to donate. We've had a lot of fun here. It's just been an incredible night. We got to meet a lot of people, a lot of influential people.
It ain't over yet. I mean,
it's not over.
We can't like tease
this whole umlaut thing and talk to you guys about the awesome event and then like not show it to you. So we're gonna like, I think, go to the fade out and the credits and all that stuff and then stay on the feed, come back in like 5 minutes and it's all gonna be live for you guys. So you get to see all the bands and all the costumes. I'm telling you, there were some people we were able to bring just because, you know, there's so many great developers and so forth that like there's costumes and everything. Like, wait till you see this one band. Seriously, it's awesome. 80s Task.
Oh yeah, I saw them out of the corner of my eye. I can't wait. So stick around after all the credits and everything. This is going to be an incredible night. Thank you guys so much. Thank you, Umlaut. Thank you, Wesley. Thank you, Rob.
The chat room.
Thank you, Carnage.
Thank you, Carnage. Me. Thank you, chat room.
Yeah.
The chat.
Almost $100 so far. We're getting
there. You go.
Awesome. That is awesome. So we got to beat last year's record, guys. 11K.
Wow.
Get to it. Get to it.
Make it happen.
All right.